It's me, AnneChan.
Hi.
Oh, best intro I've ever received.
You deserve nothing less. Okay, first, we're going to talk about the all-important SPF with you. Now, I battle with SPF because so many broke me out. I was like, I'd rather have dark spots than acne. Mm. But now that I'm getting older, my skin is changing, and I'm seeing the effect of not wearing enough SPF. So we're all crawling out of our holes now and about to actually see the sun. The light! The light! And I was wondering, man, if you could take us through this, because most people like put on the wrong amount. They don't know how to SPF. I'm one of them. Teach us everything you know.
A really easy hack to knowing how much to apply is called the two-finger rule. So Curology reports that you can do a little hack. You take your sunscreen and you put it on one finger and then the second finger. I know it seems like a lot, but this is how much you're supposed to be using for your entire face, your neck, your ears. If you don't have hair on your head, you need to use even more. Hmm. And then you take this in and you rub it in.
This is, I have to say, gonna make me want to put this on because it's fun.
Yeah.
It really is. It's like a new way in. I love this.
But if you have issues with reapplying sunscreen, because it is very important to reapply, there are a couple of ingenious products out there. These are two from Supergoop. This one is a setting spray. So if you don't want to mess up your makeup, which I love makeup, you guys know. So I am, you know, guilty of not always reapplying when I should. You can spray it on top. This one is a powder. So it's a setting powder and it has SPF and you can just go in, touch up, kind of kick back that shine and also be reapplying your sunscreen. So it's a really great thing to have in your bag. It's going to give you better protection if you apply with the two-finger rule again. But let's be real, not everyone is doing that.
Well, also, if I'm good enough to wear SPF, if I bring this with me, I don't want to cream up during the day. So this powder and this spray, major help for me to incentivize me to actually do it throughout the day.
All right, so you converted us to SPF, right? But next we have some green news. We've got the very first zero waste body wash, and it just launched this week. Fast Company reports the Plus body wash comes as a thin, almost weightless little teeny little sheet, and when it gets wet, it foams up like soap. And even better, the packaging is fully safe to just wash down the drain when you're done because it's made of natural wood pulp and dissolvable ink. All right, have you started to try any of these waterless products like this?
I have. They're actually a really big burgeoning trend in the industry. This one smells amazing. What's great about them is that when you're transporting a lot of product has a lot of water in it. It is, you know, it can have a pretty big carbon footprint. It's a lot lighter to do things that are waterless. It's actually an ingenious thing. I think we're going to see more and more of it as we progress in the industry.
I can't
Man,
wait
do
to
you have
use
any
one of these.
Bar shampoo or conditioner brands that you like out of curiosity?
Yeah, I love the one by Humankind.
Garnier is actually coming out with a new zero water soap. They're
very
just
cool.
about to launch it. And it's just so exciting because I have to say, I get very emotional about this. I am scared for us. I feel like there isn't hope. I feel like the big companies are just too big. I can't do anything as an individual. And when you see this kind of change, you believe that we are going in the right direction. Yeah. Change is possible. These incredible innovations, why not? Why are we not looking forward? Why are we staying in the same darn place? This is amazing.
This is, and it feels like a fruit roll-up.
I'm so excited
right?
about this. This is so great. Well, we can't go without plucking another fresh gem from TikTok. Glamour reports that there's a new blush hack making the rounds that gives your face a real facelift. And Mian, I would love for you to show us how to do this because let's face it, who doesn't want a facelift?
Honestly, blush can be used in so many different ways. I have this one here. This is Nectar Blush Balm by Flower. And you can do a lot of different things with blush. So you can actually contour your face with it. So I'm going to take a little bit on a brush here. And if you put your blush just on the apple of the cheek, which is a totally fine thing to do, you end up with a little bit of a flush. But if you take your blush, you can always put your finger here and actually lift it up the cheekbone. And that just instantly lifts your face without even having to use contour products, right?
I'm into this, man. I really, really, really am. And I have to say, one side of my face totally does look higher than the other.
Right? This spot right here.
Yes.
It worked.
No, it...
The matching makeup.
Totally.
Thank you. Thank you, man. I feel like I went from, like, Care Bear to Joan Crawford. Man, you're the best. I love you so much. Thank you for lifting all of us up.
I do what I can.
I love you, Mian. This is so great. I can't wait to do this with you again.